Welcome back. If you ever wondered why suddenly you are having meetings in the workplace or with your friends and family and they've suddenly transferred into potatoes or some other comedy effect? Well, we'll show you how and how to put these filters into Microsoft Teams. Hello and welcome back again. So here we go. We've also mentioned that people are now using Snapchat filters in with Microsoft Teams. But how are they doing that? Well, quite simply, they've gone online and they've downloaded the Snap Camera app. Yes, folks, if you've got a snapcamera.snapchat.com, you can then download an effect which will allow you to embellish your image with different special effects. Clicking on download takes you to the system requirements and legal license. Now, the legal license, I would encourage you to read this simply because there is quite a few legal aspects in there. Are you happy with it? Are you not happy with it? That's a decision how you need to make for yourself. And also, you've got to think about if you're using this on a works PC, what the policy is for installing applications on a work PC. Now, I use this on my own PC, which I can connect to work for. Therefore, I circumvent any sort of like standard of business conduct policy that my company uses. Once you're happy that you want to install this software, click on I've read the agreement, pop in your email, tell them that you're not a robot, make sure your machine has got the minimum operating system and hardware requirements, and download the application. Once downloaded, the Snapchat SnapCam application for PC or macOS gives you this type of interface. Now, you can select and change the live feed. Here I am now as a tomato. Or an alien. And there's a fine face. You can see it's imposed my background on this one. Or in fact, I can give myself a beard. Much hilarity can ensue from this, and it could brighten up your day. But how do you get this feed into Microsoft Teams? Well, let's check that out. Here we are in Microsoft Teams, and I've just done a quick meet me. So here I am, and here is my lovely beard that's been superimposed by the Snapchat SnapCam application. So once with that done, how do I get this image here? So click on your icon on the top right-hand side of the screen, down into settings. Now, from this settings, you can set obviously dark mode, high contrast, however you want to do it. And also you've got devices. This is where you set your audio devices, your speakers, your headphone, what mic you're using, whether you want a secondary ringer, but also the camera section. Now you can see normally I've got a Microsoft Live Cam and that will give me an image. And I'll have to stop the video feed for this and hang up. Back into settings, devices. Generally, as you can see, I've got quite a busy background with my workshop, which I always work from home from. But I've got my camera set to Microsoft Live Cam, right? That's what I'm normally set as, and people see me as I am. However, go into the drop-down box, and after you've installed the Snap Camera app, you'll get Snap Camera as a function. Click on that, and it'll go to the last filter that you've had. Clicking close to close that section. Back into the team, go into your meeting, meet now as you would normally, and here I am with my effect. Now to change the effects on the fly, I have found that sometimes the Snap Camera application automatically loads, or you have to get it from your start bar. Also the use of favorites as well is quite handy. Find something that you like. Add it as a favorite, and away you go. And here I am looking a bit like a Roswell alien. A bit spooky that, has to be said. Anyway, there you have it. Clicking off it returns the picture to normal. Thanks very much for watching. This is how to use the SnapCam application with Microsoft Teams and make your meetings perhaps a little bit easier. Things to remember and to be important. Look at your standards of business conduct. What can you possibly put onto your work PC? More than likely, nothing, because they're going to be work applications that have been ratified by your IT department. I'm using this on my home PC, which I can use pass-through authentication to connect to some Microsoft Teams meetings with my colleagues and friends and family. So that doesn't apply for me. So be warned, you can't just go installing this according to your IT policy on your work PCs. Check with them. I think it's going to be a no-no, but it's worthwhile checking because we don't want you getting in trouble by installing applications and filters just because it's funny. Everyone needs a job. Thanks for watching. Check back for more videos in the series. I'll leave you that with myself as a tomato. Check back for more videos. Catch you soon.